Hi everyone, welcome to part two of our Fiji tutorial videos for common image processing techniques. If you haven't already, be sure to click on the link for the first video in our series where we go through download and install Fiji. So today we're going to cover linear unmixing. This is a process by which you can remove competing fluorophores from your sample. And so today we have POMBI cells that express mTurk, mCherry, and YFP. And we want to get rid of those competing fluorophores and separate them into their own channels. To do that, we're going to use a series of plugins, and I'm going to list them here for you. But the idea is that we're going to go through three control images that express only each FP, and then we're going to get spectra for those, and then use those spectra to unmix a test case image. So what you're going to want to do is load your first image, and so we have a cell here expressing YFP. And so that we can see what's going on, I'm going to run a Z projection. So we're going to do a max intensity projection so that we can see what's actually in this image. I'm making no assumptions about our hardware, about your hardware, but our hardware has a 32 channel output for spectral data. Okay, and so since it's a little bit difficult to see what's going on here, I'm going to go to Image, Stacks, Z Project, and do max intensity. And this gives me a new window where I can go to Image, Adjust, Brightness and Contrast, and we can see what's going on here. So I have a yeast cell that has some spores in it after it's gone through meiosis, and I want to use this to figure out my YFP spectra. So in my original window, I'm going to run Dynamic Spectrum, JRUV1. So if I click on the main Fiji bar, type L, and then run Dynamic Spectrum, since I've selected the plugin here, I select my window and I click run. That gets me a window here where I have a box on my image, and this spectra that's shown here is due to whatever pixels are inside this box. So if I select the square ROI tool, I can resize this box, and you'll notice as I drag it around the image, I get a live update of whatever the fluorescent spectra is at each pixel position. And so I have to know a little bit about my hardware to know what exactly YFP should look like in this image. And I know that YFP should be peaked just past the 12th detector, somewhere right around in here. And so I'm gonna look for a spectra that is peaked at about this position and is fairly narrow. Most of the fluorescent protein spectra are very narrow. So that's a pretty good spectra there. Once I have this, I can click quit here on the plugin, and now I have this window. I can save it here, use these settings as your default, and then click OK, and you can save this then wherever you need to as a plot window, a PW2 file. That's important. So I go through and do this for each of the three control images that I have. So now I have three different control spectra. So I go through and open each of these, and you can see my YFP spectra, my mCherry spectra, and my mTurk spectra. So now what I want to do is do combine all trajectories. So this is going to combine all of these spectra into one window so that we can work with them together. So I select the plugin, I click run, I want to combine all series, and I want to delete the originals. So these three plot windows will go away, and I'll be left with one combined window. I click OK. Now I have all three spectra in one window, so that's nice, but they're on different scales due to the intensity of each image, so I want to normalize these spectra. So I want to go through and do normalize trajectories, JRUV1. So I highlight that plugin, I click on my window, and I click run. And I have an option here for what I can do the normalization on, and we want to do integral. So I click OK, and so now I have a new plot window out that has all three spectra normalized to the integral under each curve. So now this would be a really good plot window to save, because for any experiment where you use the same objective with the same dichroic and filter settings, you can reuse these spectra to do unmixing later. So once you have good spectra for each of them, it's a good idea to go ahead and save these for batch processing later. Okay, so now that I have all three spectra in one window, I want to go ahead and open my test case image. So that's this here. And It's also hard to see what's going on here. So I'm going to run a Z projection as well. So I go to Image, Stacks, Z Project. And again, the max intensity, and I click OK. So now you can get a little bit better idea of what's going on in this image. We have some cells here that express a combination of the fluorophores and different spores. So in my original window, remember that unmixing won't work on a max projection. In my original window, I want to do linear unmixing JRUV2. So I select that plugin. I'm going to select my window and click run. The two inputs here, I need to select my image in the image window and plot in the plot window. So test case is my image, and my PW2 file is my spectral plot. So I click OK. And then I have already normalized my spectra, so I want to deselect that. But I do want to make sure that I leave truncate negative values on. You can use the residuals, the chi-square, and the errors as a number of different troubleshooting options to see if you lose a spectra of something that's in there that you're not accounting for all the time. This is my default case to use only the setting. And I want to make sure that I go from 1 to 32. So if I click OK, I now get a new image out that's a channel image. You notice it only has three channels. Okay. And the color of the channels is completely arbitrary. So you need to go back to your plot window to figure out which channel is which. So if I click the select plus button, you'll notice that I get this spectra selected first, and that's my mTurk spectra. So channel one in this image should be CFP. So I can go to image, lookup tables, cyan. Okay. Channel two then, if I click select plus again, is the mCherry. So I want to change that to magenta, image, lookup tables, magenta. And then if I click select plus one more time, YFP is the last channel. So if I go to the last channel here, I can make this yellow. Image, lookup tables, yellow. And then finally, if I go to image, color, channels tool, I can make a composite here that shows all three colors. So remember, in this case, we've had three images that had the three different spectra so that we could use them for reference. It's also possible to do unmixing where you don't have control images for each color. And the process is basically the same, but in that case, you'll go through with dynamic spectrum JRUV1, and you'll find in the same image each of the fluorescent species that you want to account for. Save those as new plot windows, and then follow this as usual. Okay, that's it. I hope to see you next time. Thank you.